Functions in Lua are first-class objects, and technically all of them are anonymous. Let's talk about what that actually means and how we can use that knowledge to, among other things, create callback functions. The first thing you need to know is that the way you have been creating functions in Lua is just syntax sugar. This is what it actually looks like under the hood. The function is assigned to a variable and does not have a name. An anonymous function is a function without a name. This is the reason one could say that all functions in Lua are anonymous. However, I personally only call a function anonymous if it has not been assigned to a variable. So, does that mean that we can have a function which is not assigned to a variable? The answer to that is yes. Since functions are first-class objects, they can be used exactly like any other value, such as strings, numbers, and booleans. A variable has a left value, which is the variable name, and a right value, which is the assigned data. Both the left and right value can be passed as an argument, assigned to a variable, returned from a function, assigned to a key inside of a table. And all of these things apply to functions in the exact same way. We can assign the right value to a variable, as well as the left value. We can pass functions as arguments. This function is just an example which takes a function as an argument and calls it, while this second function is the function which we are going to pass. We are now able to pass the left value, like this, as well as pass the right value, like this. We are also able to return a function via the return keyword. This applies to both the left and right value. The same thing goes for assigning a function to a key inside of a table. One of the interesting things which we can do using this knowledge is to create callback functions. A callback function is a function which we can pass into another function, which will store it and call back at a later point in time. One of the best examples of this is a timer, which will call a function after a specific amount of time has elapsed. Here is a quick timer class that I created. If this looks intimidating, check out my video on object-oriented programming in Lua. The key parts to this class is that it takes two arguments. First, the duration, and then the callback function. When we call the add function, the newly created instance is inserted into a local table named active. We then loop through all of the active timers and call the update function on them. Here, their duration is decremented until it reaches zero. When that occurs, it will call its callback function and then remove itself. Let's test adding a timer. First, I will pass in the duration. 3 seconds should be enough. Then we pass in a function. Like I mentioned before, this could be either a left value or a right value. The most common in a situation like this is to use the latter, and pass in an anonymous function. If we run the program, you can see that it prints hello after 3 seconds. If you have ever used the built-in table.sort function, you may have encountered passing functions before. This is a built-in Lua function which is, like the name suggests, used to sort the order of a table. To demonstrate this, I have created a table named people, which contains a few tables with a name and score. I want to sort this table based on the score, in descending order. To do that, we will call table.sort. The first argument is the table which we want to sort. Then it expects a function, which takes two arguments. I will name them A and B. When table.sort uses this function, it will pass in the two elements which it wants to compare, and expects it to return true if the first argument, A, should come first in the sorted table. To accomplish this, I will return A.score is greater than B.score. To verify that this actually works, I will print the order of the table before sorting, and then once again after sorting. If we run the program, you can see that the table gets sorted as expected. Let's look at another function-related concept. Self-invoking functions. Here I have a simple function which takes a string as an argument, compares that string and returns a function. For example, if the string is morning, then it will return a function which prints good morning. We can now call this function and store the return function in a variable. If I run the program, nothing will print, because all we have done is stored the function, not called it. If we want to run the code inside of the function, we need to call it. As you can see, it now prints good day. There is a neat trick which allows us to do this in a single line of code. All we need to do is add a second pair of parentheses. It will now first get the function and then call it. As you can see, it still does the same thing. In fact, we don't even need to assign it to a variable. Let's say that we have a function which we want to call immediately after declaring it. To demonstrate this, I will make a quick function which just prints hello world. If we wrap the function in a parentheses, we are able to add the additional pair of parentheses at the end, just like in the previous example. If we run the program, you can see that we have created a self-invoking function, or in other words, a function which calls itself. That is it for this video. I hope you found it useful. Let me know down in the comments if any of this is new to you, or if you have any other feedback. Another way to reach out is through our awesome Discord server, so if you haven't joined that yet, what are you waiting for? Remember to leave a like and subscribe so you don't miss any future videos.